viewers, namaskar. An echo of frost and snow covering the evergreens outside. Signing in, I am Sapna Ranta Tehreek, Faculty Institute of Hotel Management, extending you a very warm and a heartily welcome. I appreciate and value your presence. I will be your facilitator for conducting these series of video practical sessions for the subject accommodation operation on the topic flower arrangement for third and fourth semester of BSc Hospitality and Hotel Administration. We are intrigued to manifest you to the basic skill and art called for the preparation of flower arrangement, invoking you a practical advice along with artistic skills. The module on flower arrangement constitutes of 5 submodules, persuading further certain to catch sight of them. The prerequisites to the modules are basic knowledge about the flower arrangement, its importance in enhancing the beauty of the hotel's interior and the premises around, along with good features of design as applicable to flower arrangement, their classification, buying, aftercare, pre-preparations, etc. Lastly, followed with the concerns of placement and the location in hotel premises for the flower arrangements. Straightforwardly, the intent and objective of these demonstrational video sessions is that by the end of these sessions, you will be able to explain the importance of the aesthetics created by the flower arrangements. Secondly, you'll be able to accomplish and devise the concern for buying cut flowers, their conditioning and aftercare. Thirdly, particularize and pick out tool of the trade, that is the basic ingredients and materials required for preparations in the flower arrangement. Fourthly, numerate, put into sets, spot and specify the different styles of flower arrangement. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the whole affair about. Finally, construct and assemble the different styles of flower arrangement with respect to the modus operandi whilst applying the 8 good features of designing in flower arrangements. Enjoy, give it a go, DIY. Henceforth, let's begin consecutively, aiming to achieve all the 5 objectives. Let's begin with the basic course of action. Here, I'm going to show you some different types of flowers that I have around in my lab, along with the basic cure and conditioning that we would do to these cut flowers. The flower arrangement room is majorly equipped with a running water, along with the sink, where all the pre-preps are done as far as preparation of flower arrangement goes. Let's proceed further and see to it what all things goes as far as pre-preparations are concerned. As you could see here, we have bucket full of water and bins full of water along with a basin where I've soaked in an oasis a night before the preparations of these flower arrangements. As you could see, this basin is full of water and the temperature remains 45 degrees Celsius. So what I'm going to do as a part of conditioning, I'm going to give a slant cut with the help of these pruning scissors, and that has to be done inside the waters, giving a slant or a V cut. For a simple reason, as you could see, for a simple reason that we do not create air bubbles which could result in wilting of the flowers. So in order to prevent this, we will immerse it deep in the water and give it a slant cut. Alright, the flower that I'm holding on my hand, this is an orchid and this is one of my favorite flowers. As far as cure and conditioning of the flowers is concerned, here we should remember one thing, that is cut these flowers early morning or after the sunset as they are filled with water and crisp enough. As you could see, the stem of orchid, it is already immersed in a tube, a small tube, and this carries a preservative. Flowers, when stored in the pantry, they should be covered with the newspaper or a piece of paper and bind it in a bundle and then put in the bin filled of water. And next to it is, whenever you're supposed to carry these flowers out, you're supposed to carry them heads down position. Next to the care and conditioning steps, we have this flower called chrysanthemum, and it has a tendency to lose its leaves from the bottom. So in order to strictly adhere these leaves to their positions, what we could do is we could simply dribble the candle wax onto the back side of the flower. As you could see, we've dribbled a little amount of candle wax on the back side of these petals, so in order they are being anchored to the flower. As far as the preparation of a rose stem is concerned, avoid dethorning the thorns for a simple reason that it shortens the life of a rose flower. To sum it up, a flower or a leaf cut from a plant has a shorter, though a beautiful life. So, in order to prolong this for a little while, we can adhere to the care and conditioning which I just spoke to you. As far as floral decors are concerned, there are certain tones, or I would say tips, that we should consider. Them are: avoid direct exposure to the draught, say for example fan or AC or a window, and also please avoid putting these arrangements of flowers close to a sunlight or large appliances, as this would prevent dehydration. Allow me now to take you to the familiarization tour of the basic materials and ingredients required in the preparations of these floral decors in order to maintain them fresh and long-lasting. So let's just begin with the first main ingredient, which is the mechanics. Mechanics, these are the items which are used to keep in place the plant material within the container. First one being the floral foam. This is oasis green in color. It should be soaked 1.5 hours for the fresh plant materials prior to their preparations. Oasis has a tendency to increase its weight 30 times when soaked in water. Next up is the chicken wire, which is required to hold the oasis up together in large floral arrangements. Next up in my hand, I have Kenzen. It is a pin holder, and it is a heavy metal pin holder. I have it in different shapes, as you could see this, and sizes. This is majorly used when we prepare Japanese style of flower arrangement, say in a mori mano or ukibana, where you have these floral arrangements, and there you would want in a floating arrangement to hold up to the floral stems. Next up is these stub wires, and these are, they are also available in varied colors, and the usage of the same is that they could be molded in any form and any shape in a flower arrangement. If you require any falling plant or a stem to hold up on, then we can use these stub wires. As you could see, these could be folded or molded into any form or shape. Flower in my hand is a pink carnation, and as you could see, the stem has broken off, and since the flower is really beautiful and blooming up, and I would want to use it again in my arrangement. So what I do is, with the help of this stuff wire, I'm going to roll it around this stem and help it stand firmly, guided by a position. As you could see, I have this double tape which allows me to fix a Kenzen to a vase or a bowl, a shallow bowl, and I have these floral tapes which I can use in my flower arrangement. Preferably, I will be showing you their usage when I give you a demonstration on these flower arrangement preparations. In addition to all of these, I have these toothpicks which I will use and I may use in the preparations of the flower arrangement to, you know, put the oases together when I'm using multiple oases. Next on the table, friends, I've got a set of equipments which will be used to ensure that a satisfactory arrangement of plant materials is created within a container. So these equipment, they aid to help to prepare these flower arrangement. And what I have here is, this is a turntable which I will be using when preparing flower arrangement in order to avoid me moving around or to and fro. I just can make the turntable turn around while I'm doing these flower arrangements. Next to it is cicatures. These are used to cut the hard or the woody stems of the plant material. And then I have a pruning scissor which I majorly use to cut the stems in the flower arrangements. And then I have a knife which I use to cut the oases or the floral form, as we know. With addition to all of what I've just spoken to you about, of what we've just seen, now I have this mister bottle which is used to spray water onto the flower arrangements. I have this bucket of stationeries, a glue gun, some paint brushes and scales which I would require in my preparations, preferably if I would want to do so. And then I have these pair of gloves which I can wear, or which we can wear while we are preparing these floral arrangements. And these are certain spray paints or spray paint colors used for spraying instant colors to the arrangement. I have a golden, a pink and a silver. Okay, now I'm showcasing containers. These are majorly the receptacles that hold flower arrangements. So what I expect them, or what should they be like? They should be plain and not that much intricate in pattern. As the idea here is, they should be simple, plain and easy. They need to detract attention, and also they have to be simple neutral colors, and maybe waterproof containers are advisable. And I have here varied shape and sizes of containers. We have brass containers here for different shapes and sizes and for different styles of flower arrangement. Say for example, if we have to create a low flower arrangement or a shallow flower arrangement, we would require this type of container. And also you could see the shape is round, it's round in shape. So majorly the arrangements that will be made on this type of container or within this type of container will be round arrangements. Example, a posy will be best suitable for this kind of container. Next to it is followed up by these baskets, which are really famous as far as takeaways are concerned for flower arrangement. And this is majorly used in Japanese style of flower arrangement. In addition to these containers, I have these miscellaneous objects which could be used for the preparation of flower arrangement. Like this is a candle cup, margarita glass, and also a small little fancy basket along with various mugs of any type of shape, size, color or form that could be used in the preparation of these decors. Bringing it up next into the list are the bases. These are the objects which are majorly placed underneath the container. These are responsible for adding beauty to the display and visual appeal. Table mats are a good example of a base. Say, for example, if I have to place this on a table, this is how I am going to use the table mat. In order to prevent the support as well as the container from scratches and other things. And also, with addition to this table mat, I can use, say, to create a visual appeal with reference to the base. Support are majorly the center table, the side table, example the credenzas or the alcoves or the sideboards on which we happen to place these floral decors. Here I have this small pet table which I've used as a center table, and here I'm placing this flower arrangement. So this table now is acting as a support in for this cozy arrangement. Next up in the queue are these non-plant decorative materials. They happen to create extra interest and are functional at times. Say for example, you could use these candles in a flower arrangement and lit up for a beautiful candlelight dinner. We have these goodies, Christmas goodies, as you could see, these bells and balls, some gift wrapped small dolls, little baskets. They could be used in the flower arrangement. This is potpourri. These are dried scented flowers. They're my favorite, personal favorite. And also you could use them in your houses. This is the butter paper, as I've told you earlier also. So I've got some beautiful colors here in. Maybe nice fluorescent green is here. And then I have this fuchsia, or you could say a fluorescent pink color also I have, which I will show you how I am going to use it in my displays further. As you know, flowers breathe fresh air into any space, and they are predominantly relative to happiness. So as you could see, I have these variety of flowers available with me, which I am going to use in my flower arrangement or demonstrational videos. So let me just give you a quick tour of what all type of flowers I am having. Let's just begin with the plant material, which is flowers, and this is called the line flowers. First in the plant material are the flowers, which have line flowers. These are responsible for creating height or length or the periphery of the arrangements. And why I call them line flowers? For a simple reason, as you could see, they are arranged in a sequence moving upwards. And also they say that line flowers in a flower arrangement depict movement in life, which I will get back to you when I do this Japanese or Oriental style of flower arrangement. Next to it is round flowers, and I have, as you could see, the name of this flower is gladiolus, and called as nicknamed as glads. This is a pink glad. Now I have a round flower. The name of this flower is carnation. The flower that I have in my hand is a rose flower, and this is also this is called a round flower or a focal flower. The idea of this flower in an arrangement is to create dominance or a focal point. Flower is anthurium. This is lily. Gerberas. They're available in multiple colors. You can choose them according to your choice, and you could also decide them depending upon the theme and the design of the place where you're going to place these arrangements. This is gypsophilia. It is a secondary plant material, and the idea to, or it is also known as baby's breath. Idea to have this these fillers in an arrangement is to fill in the spaces between flowers and the foliage. These are this is the leafy material, or this is the foliage that is being used in the flower arrangement, or well known as the green material, which is used in the flower arrangement. So I have this is Erica palm. As you could see, this is Erica palm. Prepared it in certain shape and style to fit into my floral design. Next to it is, this is famously known as Sun of India, it is also a foliage. This is these are majorly secondary foliages used in the arrangements. Then I have very famous abundantly found here in Shimla. These are the ferns. This is asparagus ferns, and this is being used in the arrangement to hide on the spaces or to hide on the oasis if seen through. And next to it is the dried flower material. For this I've earlier also spoken to you. These are jute sticks. Jute sticks, they've been colored into, given these different shades of color. And then I have these normal broom sticks in which are being colored, and which have got these sparkles added onto it and spray painted. And these I'm going to use in the dried flower arrangements. Concluding to this video session, flower arrangements are simplified and effective way to amplify the welcome setting of any given space or occasion. Signing off, in the next upcoming video, I am going to show you flower arrangements, different styles, their classification, spotting and specifying with reference to the flower arrangement principle as applicable. We will see how to construct and assemble the various flower arrangement with reference to the modus operandi as well as the art and skill applied to the arrangements. Until then, happy learning. Watch out for the next uploads. Very exciting and highly surprising. Stay tuned.